Listen, friends, listen this story about the two clevers, about the king and his servant. It's about them arguing. Listen, friends, listen this story about the two clevers, about the king and his servant. It's about them arguing. Never ending, endless talking, it brings joy and colors here. Many dishes are cooked here without the ingredients. Even then, hidden knowledge is always there in argument. No one stands in front of them and fumes their smoke as well. Both wise men are intellectual, yet they argue on and on about the king and his servant. It's about them arguing. Listen, friends, listen this story about the two clevers, about the king and his servant. It's about them arguing.
Your Majesty, recently I've heard that in Akbar's kingdom, there is an intelligent scholar named Birbal, and I have heard that no one can take his place.
Yes, sir. He can solve anything and everything. No matter however huge the problem is, he will not let anybody down ever.
I have heard that he is the son of soil. But King Akbar was so impressed with him that he asked Birbal to join him as the member of his court, and he is also appointed as the special advisor.
This is great. How intelligent he must be. But I haven't really seen this to believe it. I can't believe it without witnessing it. I have to meet him now. Yes. Let's do it. Oh, please relax. I was just snapping my fingers.
My lord, are you very sure you want to do this? And you really think you can do this?
Come on, don't worry, Indrajit. I know very well what I am doing. And you know very well that I can easily enter the palace by hiding my identity.
Yes, I know you can do this, but this time it's not just about stepping out of the palace, but you're going to Agra. Your Majesty, I know you have understood what exactly I want to convey. Okay then, so you won't budge, right?
Thank you, Indrajit. Thank you very much. I will never ever forget this favor.
You're welcome, sir. But take care and come back safely. You know that I'm not in favor of this, but still, go safely. Come back soon. My best wishes are with you, okay?
Don't worry, Indrajit. Just take care in my absence. And yes, please inform everyone that I have gone to Jairampur to relax for a few days. I have full faith in you, Indrajit, that you will manage everything with ease. All right. I will see you soon. Hello, I am Raj Chauhan. I am on my way to Agra. So why don't we both travel together? Come, accompany me, brother.
Thank you. My name is Ravi Sharma. I am a servant in a trader's place in Kanpur. While I was on my way, some burglars looted me. And they also beat me really badly. And they even took my horse away from me. I did manhandle them as well. But I ended up injuring my leg. And that is why you can see me limping now.
I am on my way to Agra. Why don't we both travel together? Come, accompany me, brother.
Thank you so much, sir. Really, you are very kind.
Finally reached Agra. So it's time we part our ways now. We shall meet some other time. Hey, I'm talking to you. I have reached my destination, so please get down now.
Me? Why should I get down? This horse belongs to me. If you wish to go, then you can definitely leave.
What? Traitor? You cheat? Get down, you ungrateful monster, or else I shall.
Else you shall? What are you going to do then, tell me?
I will have to teach you a lesson.
Leave me. Why are you hitting
get
me?
Get down.
No.
Get down, you ungrateful
monster.
No, I won't
monster. Get down from horse.
Please don't do that. Please wait. You can't solve the problem like that. I suggest you that meet Pandit Birbal. He will surely help you.
Yes, I am ready. Let's go there and get this problem solved at once.
All right, I am ready too.
I have made up my mind. I will never help a stranger now.
This man doesn't seem like a trader. He seems to be from a royal family. Anyways, that can be sorted out later.
So, finally I get to witness Birbal's intelligence today.
All right. So, I have heard both of you. You may leave now and let the horse be here till tomorrow. And whoever will be the real master of this horse can take it from the stable tomorrow morning. Am I clear?
Pardon me, Your Majesty. But a messenger wants to meet you now. I asked him to come tomorrow morning, but he totally refuses to budge. He wants to meet you, Your Majesty.
Send him in. He might have some urgent work.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Yes. So we have to find out to whom this horse belongs to. Since you both claim that the horse belongs to you, now this is what you'll have to do. Go to the stable, find your horse and take it home. Ravi, you may go first. Yes, but some of our soldiers will accompany you.
I will find my horse in a jiffy. I don't think it's gonna be difficult for me.
Come on, hurry up. We don't have much time. Quickly find your horse and yes, don't wait here, okay?
Please pardon me, sir. But I am unable to identify my horse.
Then why are you wasting our time? Please go. Let the other person come. Go outside.
Okay. Now it's your turn, Raj Chauhan.
Raja, how are you now? Come, let's go home. Enough of this tiring journey.
Raj Chauhan, so you are the true master of this horse. And Ravi Sharma, this is how you show your gratitude for helping you? Liar, thief, cheater? Soldiers, please take him away and punish him accordingly.
Your Majesty, please pardon me. I shall not commit this mistake again.
Wait, Your Majesty. How can you leave so soon from here?
Did you just address me, Your Majesty?
Your Majesty, I know everything. You are Chandra Varma, the King of Tripura. Just wait for a while. I want you to meet someone.
I was worried about you, sir. That's why I kept following you till here. Please forgive me, my lord.
Oh, sir, you are our guest of honor today. I'm really sorry for the humiliation you had to face here today. I want you to experience our hospitality. And yes, one small suggestion. Henceforth, please don't hide your identity and roam around like this. This is a humble request. On behalf of our intelligent friend, great Pandit Birbal.